Welcome to One Chemistry. Always do your best. Now, let us see about Bayer-Villiger oxidation. It is a very important reaction in organic chemistry. It involves oxidation as well as rearrangements. We will see mechanism and 20 best examples. Stay tuned. What is inside this video? Inside this video, we will see what is Bayer-Villiger oxidation, then the mechanism behind the oxidation, then the migratory aptitude. This is a very much important thing. You should know which group will migrate. Then we will see the best examples. It can be on migration, or it can be on selectivity, or it can be on adamantane, sometime in bicyclic system. We will see one by one. At first, let us see what is Bayer-Villiger oxidation. It is a just oxidation reaction. If you take heat on, just it will be insertion of oxygen will be there. So, heat on will converted into ester there. Here, catalyst is peracet. The peracet donates oxygen. So, the final product will be ester. The catalyst here can be peracet or perfluoroacetic acid or benzoic peracet or simple peroxide or metachlorobenzoic acid also. Main purpose of this catalyst is it should donate the oxygen. It is often considered as rearrangement reaction. Why? Because the R group migrates after O, so it's called rearrangement. The simple trick for this reaction is just insert the R between the migratory group. So it's very easy. Let us see the mechanism behind this. Here I highlighted the migrating group with orange circle. The catalyst, what it happened is, the catalyst just added to the carbonyl group, hydrogen on oxygen, remaining part on the electrophilic carbon. So, the group attached, just addition reaction happened. So, the R which will migrate, the migration happened simultaneously with the formation of heat on there. So, the final product will be ester. The important thing you should know from this is, there is a formation of CO bond, breaking of CC bond because the R group migrates, and breaking of OO bonds also. It's an oxidation reaction as well as rearrangement. Since this many things are happening, it is very much important. Here one important thing you should know. The moving group always trans to the peroxide oxygen. So the migration happens easily. The position is particularly antiperpendicular position, so it's easy. So which group will migrate is a very important thing. The migrating ability is called migratory aptitude. Normally electron rich group will mobilize. So normally which is electron rich? Alkyl group. Obviously tertiary is better, secondary or primary, or phenyl group. The electron donating group and phenyl group is much better. Electron withdrawing group is the least one. So the ethoxide phenyl is higher one. The nitrophenyl is the least one. Overall, if you see, the hydrogen migratory aptitude is very high. Methyl is very least. You can say this way, high electron density is migrated first, low electron density groups are migrated last. So, it's all about stability of cation. So, you can understand it much better by the order. The important thing you should know is stearic effect also influence, which is higher than the migratory aptitude. We will see one by one. Let us see the first example, which is cyclic ketone. The what is the final product? It's a cyclic ester which is called lactone. How it is forming? The first step is attack of peracet, the addition reaction, H added to O and peracet at carbonyl carbon. So the migration of the ring carbon will happen. So the 6-member ring will become 7-member ring. At last the cation compensated by the hydrogen, so ketone will be there. So finally the cyclic ester lactone is formed. It is very interesting. If you want to understand it simply, just insert the oxygen between the migratory group. Let us see the second example. Here the two possibilities are there with the product. The reactant is cyclopropyl methyl ketone. What will be the product? Which group will migrate? So everybody guess methyl is better, ring strain is there. No. Here cyclopropyl group is very stable due to its perpendicular p orbital towards cation. So it's a very stable because of its resonance ability. Here you can see from the diagram. So this group will migrate. Again, the mechanism is same. Parasite attack on CO, so carbon attacks. Then the cation will be formed. The cation compensated by the hydrogen. Finally, hydrogen will be there. Here you should consider the always cation stability. Cyclopropyl is stable. That's why the product formation. Then the next example, which is bicyclic ketone, which will be the product. Here you are using the parasite, so the oxidation happen at the double bond or ketone or between the ring or after the bridged carbon. Here also you have to use stable cation concept. The bridged cation is stable, that's why it's formed. Moreover, the bridged cation is also a conjugated cation, that's why it's stable. So the mechanism is same, attack of H and O, then the migration of bridged carbon. Finally, the bridged carbon attached ester will come. So it is easy once you understand the carbocation stability. The next example on steric vector. Here also bicycloketone. There are the two possibilities. Oxygen can form near to the bridge or oxygen form away from the bridge. Here you can simply guess oxygen near to the bridge. Simply it's a tertiary cation. No, it is not. Because the bridge is crowded by methyl group and bridged carbon. So it is very much crowded. Even though it's a tertiary cation, the whole group cannot move migrated. So the bridge cannot move. So the primary cation move. So ester will form away from the oxygen. The mechanism is same. Attack of parasite, formation of, then the compensation of cation. Next example is sun selectivity. Triketone is there. Which one will form here? The oxygen insertion between the ketones or oxygen is near to the ring. There are the two possibilities. Let us see which one will form. Here we have to know the fact that acyl cation is stable because of the lone pair on the oxygen. So there is a resonance stability, acyl cation is stable. So you have to break the ring in such a way that acyl cation formation. So let us see what will happen. Here we have to see the diketone is there. Attack of COOH can be on any carbon, but you have to balance the acyl cation. So the attack on the second carbonyl group will be happened. Then the migration of CO, which is the acyl cation. Finally, the carbocation compensated by the hydrogen. So you should know if dication is the reactant, oxygen always inserted between the diketones. Then let us see the common examples. So mechanism is all the same. So I straight away given the product. Here the sixth example where methyl and ethyl groups are between the ketone. Where it will be inserted? It is inserted between ethyl because ethyl cation is stable. Then the seventh example. There is a bridged ketone. The oxygen insertion make it as a four member ring. The reaction is promoted by the strain. So the ring strain promote the reaction here. Then the 8th example, there is a ketone, one side is phenyl group attached to the nitrogen, another side is benzene. So which group will migrate? We very well know that electron rich group will migrate. But NO2 is electron withdrawing group, so the ring will be electron deficient. So the oxygen inserted between the phenyl group, so the product will be on phenylic ester. Then the 9th example, the ketone, both sides are asymmetrical, one side methyl attached, other side hydrogen. So where the oxygen insertion will be happen? Again you have to know the stability of cation. So tertiary cation is stable. So the oxygen inserted between the more substituted carbon. Then the 10th example, again one side methyl, another side phenyl methyl. Where the oxidation happen? Oxidation happen on phenyl side. Why? Because the cation stabilized by phenyl group, that's why it's stable. Then the 11th example, which is very much interesting. There is a substitution CF3 and the other side is hydrogen. Which side will happen? Here you should not see which cation is stable. Here CF3 is electron withdrawing group, so it reduces the electron density. So the oxygen insertion will happen on the other side. Then the next example, where the benzaldehyde, where the oxidation will happen here. Oxidation will happen easily on the hydrogen side because hydrogen has the migratory aptitude much better. So hydrogen will migrate, final product will be benzoic acid. Then the next example, the ketone attached with one side methyl, another side cyclohexane. We very well know that cyclohexane has tertiary carbon there. So the migration happened with the tertiary carbon. So the oxygen insertion between the cyclohexyl group. The next example is the interesting one. The competition between phenyl group and tertiary butyl group. Which group will migrate? According to the competition, the migratory aptitude of butyl group is much better than phenyl. So the oxygen will be inserted between the tertiary butyl group and carbonyl group. Then the next example. The example contained bicyclic system on one side, phenyl on other side. So we have to see which one is better for the migration. The bicyclic system is forming tertiary carbon. Mostly it is like cyclohexyl system. That's why the cation is stable. So the migration happened with bicyclic system. So oxygen inserted between carbonyl group and bicyclic system. Then the next and interesting example. The 5-member and 4-member fused system, the carbonyl group and 4-member system. So the oxygen insertion happened at which side? Here also you have to see the stability. Tertiary is stable or primary is stable. So tertiary is much more stable cation form. So tertiary cation on the ring side. So the oxygen inserted between ring and the carbonyl. So 5-member ring will be formed. Here the driving force also a ring strain. Then the next example is an adamantane. The carbonyl group is a very symmetrical system, more than you imagine. So oxygen happen at any time is no problem. So the adamantane also involving in the 7-member ring formation. Even though it's a stable system, it can also form 7-member ring. Then the next example, here also the steric effect come into play. The migration happen with bridged carbon or other side carbon. Here bridged carbon with a tertiary butyl group, which is a very bulky group, it cannot mobilize easily. So the oxygen happen away from the bridge. So the steric effect here is stronger than the migratory aptitude. So the oxygen insertion on the other side. Then the next example, carbonyl group attached with nitro attached benzene and methyl attached benzene. Here you have to calculate the electron density. Nitro is the electron withdrawing group, decrease the electron density. Methyl same time increase the electron density. So the migration happened with the methyl group. It is a stabler one. Let us summarize what we've seen. Stabilized cation always migrates, the very important point. So how you consider the cation stability? Resonance stabilize the cation, plus inductive groups, which is the electron donating group, stabilize the cation, minus inductive groups, which destabilize the cation, and the conjugated lone pair also stabilize the cation. Moreover, if you have the competition between steric effect and migration, steric effect dominates on the influence. That's all from me today. I hope it was useful. Thanks for watching.